Thank you so much for watching Landumc Goes There. Please subscribe and hit the like button and the bell notification button. Straw Dogs is a 1971 psychological thriller film that was directed by Sam Peckinpah. It stars Dustin Hoffman and Susan George. The screenplay was written by Peckinpah and David Goodman and is based upon Gordon Williams' 1969 novel that's called The Siege of Trencher's Farm. Its basic storyline is that David Sumner, played by Dustin Hoffman, is a mild-mannered academic from the United States. He marries Amy, played by Susan George, who's an English woman. In order to escape the hectic stateside lifestyle, David and his wife relocate to a small town near Cornwall, where Amy was raised at. There, David is ostracized by the brutish men of the village, including one of them being Amy's old flame, Charlie. Eventually, the taunts escalate, and two of the locals end up assaulting Amy. This assault awakens a shocking, violent side that David never knew he had. The movie is noted for its violent sequences, and it was released the same year as A Clockwork Orange, The French Connection, and Dirty Harry. And this sparked a film controversy over the perceived increase of violent films in general. The movie premiered in the UK in November of 1971. Although being really controversial at that time, Straw Dogs is considered by some critics to be one of Peckinpah's best films. It was nominated for an Academy Award for Best Original Dramatic Score. Its star, Dustin Hoffman, is usually not a fan of violent films, and it was kind of strange when he took this role. The talk was that the real reason he did it was strictly for the money. Before shooting ever started, Peckinpah instructed him and Susan George to live together for 2 weeks. They also threw in the co-writer David Goodman into the mix. And it went on to turn out that this arrangement and the interactions that happened during this 2-week period were really worked into some of the film's final script. The title of the movie comes from a Chinese philosopher who wrote, "Heaven and earth are not humane, and regard the people as straw dogs." Straw dogs were used as a ceremonial object for religious sacrifices in ancient China. In typical Sam Peckinpah fashion, there were wild parties and a lot of drinking going on after filming had stopped daily. One of the actors actually got hurt by breaking his arm at a wild party that they were throwing. It's even said that the film was put into jeopardy when the co-writer and director caught pneumonia after an all-night drinking session in the sea at Land's End. After Peckinpah recuperated in a London clinic, he was reinstated to the film after he promised that he would remain sober for the rest of the shoot. I doubt that that happened. A significant difference between the novel and the film is that in the novel, the Sumner couple have a daughter who is also trapped in the farmhouse with them. Peckinpah removed this daughter from the script, and he rewrote the character of Amy as a younger, more liberated woman. The writer of the book, Gordon Williams, was so upset with the adaptation of his novel that he vowed he would never sell another work to an American company. Dustin Hoffman disagreed with the casting of Susan George in the role. He felt like his character would never marry a Lolita-styled girl like this. But Peckinpah insisted on George, and he wouldn't back down, even though she was an unknown actress at that time. The village of St. Buryan was used as the location for the filming, with some of the locals appearing as extras in the film. These extras were not aware of the nature of the film at its time of shooting, and they were most upset to discover upon its release that they had been used in a film of this nature, which is so inconsistent with their moral values. In early production, Peckinpah contacted Elliot Gould about the lead in the film, but Gould was already committed to another lead in another film and couldn't do it. They considered quite a few other actors in the process. Those included Beau Bridges, Stacy Keach, and Jack Nicholson. This is the first of three movies that David Warner appears in under the direction of Sam Peckinpah. He was in The Ballad of Cable Hogue. It was done around the same time as this film. And then he was also in what was considered Peckinpah's last classic, Cross of Iron. In both this movie and Cable, David helps to end the entire picture. In Cable, he says a sermon, and in this movie, he's sitting with Dustin Hoffman as they drive off to an unknown destination. In order to express a sick enjoyment in the scene where Dustin Hoffman beats the man on the floor to death, he requested that they would put coconuts there for him to smash. In one of those shots, you can actually see a bit of coconut flying off into the distance. The director passed this off as brain matter and left it in the completed final cut. When director Peckinpah was planning the scene in which Amy is assaulted twice, he wouldn't tell her how he was going to shoot the scene. Under pressure from her, he eventually told her bluntly that he was going to show her being assaulted, included in those shots, full nudity from her. She flat refused to take part in his plans for that scene, and she threatened to resign. He eventually relented, allowing George to depict Amy's trauma by concentrating on her eyes and face rather than her body. The only nudity that you see in the film is from the waist up. In the scene where David Sumner, played by Dustin Hoffman, first enters the local pub, the director was completely unhappy with the way the other actors' reactions were when they saw this stranger entering their world. Eventually, he decided to do one take where Hoffman entered the scene without his trousers on. He got the reaction that he was looking for, and these shots were shown in the final cut of the film. This movie has Peckinpah written all over it and includes his primitive vision of violence, his belief that manhood requires rites of violence that must be defended by blood, and that a man must conquer other men to prove his courage and to hold on to his woman. Take a look at this well-done Peckinpah film. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll continue to chase the classics.